There's that shark we were talking about that one of our students described. This is a shark from Oman, from the Western Indian Ocean. And as Katherine mentioned, it was collected about 20 years ago. These guys were just doing some diving, recreational diving, and they had a little book, underwater ID book, and they couldn't identify this thing. So they were smart enough to bring three specimens back, and it turned out that when it got here, we couldn't identify it, and it turned out to be a new species. And then 15 years later, when Zach arrived and wanted to do something, I suggested he pull this out and describe it. So he wrote a paper, put a name on it, and published it. It's a kind of shark called a horn shark, because of these kind of horny buttresses on top of the eye. Benthic thing, lives on the bottom. We've got three of these. It's still pretty rare in collections, I don't think. So, I mean, this tank, every single specimen in here has a story. So when you asked about stories, we could go on forever. Anglerfishes, you've heard me talk about anglerfishes forever, but in here there are a number of different kinds of anglerfishes. This is a coral reef variety. They can get pretty big, like 3 feet long. This is a thing with a lure. Actually, its lure is broken off, but that's a coral reef variety. This is a deep sea anglerfish. This is the kind that have the dwarf males. You've heard the story. The sexual dimorph, the males and females are tremendously different in size. These females get to be about 3 feet long. The males never get to be about more than three inches.
Yeah.
And so they find the females and bite onto her body, and they fuse to her. You know. And the female then, the blood systems fuse, and so then he lives off the nutrients in her blood. He becomes a parasite on her, and that's how they get together. And then, of course, it has this wonderful lure on top of its head. So she sits down there wiggling this thing. It's bioluminescence. She lives 1,000, 2,000 meters where it's pitch black, and she lights this light, and she wiggles it, and things come to her, and she gobbles them up. So this is a shallow water anglerfish. It sits on the bottom, and it's got this lure on the top of its head. You've probably seen this at Pike Place. So interesting animal, huh?
Yeah, so that one you wouldn't know if it was male or female.
No. Although,
and people eat this. They call it poor man's lobster.
Yeah. I ate it in Japan. They eat everything. They eat the, we had a little liver bowl, and it's a little, like, the size of silver dollars, a thick thing. Really good. So I have to put this on. This helps to just keep everything moist. If anything's sticking out of alcohol,
Once it's in alcohol, the only thing that could really damage it over hundreds of years is if it dries out.
Oh, wow. What kind of shark is it?
A spiny dogfish, small as acanthius. So they're common in Puget Sound.
And how?
We don't know the history of this. It's been here forever, and nobody has any data on it. It's just been here. We have no idea.
How often would you see the occurrence of a two-headed fish?
Well, typically something like that you'd imagine would get eaten pretty quickly.
Yeah, so, stands out.
Yeah, and it, you know, it obviously didn't make it very far. You can see where the yolk sac was attached here. So these are halibut eggs. So halibut, you know, get to be over 500 pounds is the record. But they start out as just these tiny little eggs. So that's why we have, you know, millions, because you can fit a zillion in one little container.